What's up, SaaS Masters? My name is George, and today I want to show you a deal that lets you personalize images and videos. This video is going to help you out to understand what the deal is about, what is it for, how to actually use it, and I'm going to make an integration with a form to send out an email with that personalized image. Now, it sounds kind of strange, but it's actually straightforward, and this video is going to clear up any doubt that you might have about this deal. Let me start off by saying what it actually does. Like I said before, it personalizes the image or video. So what it does is basically from an input variable that you're going to grab, like just say the name that someone typed in, well, you're going to grab that name and you're going to put it in the image. What's the idea? To put a personalized image where it says like, hi, Jorge or George. And it's gonna look really cool. So what is it gonna help you with? Well, you're gonna wow your clients because they're gonna view an image that has their name in it or other variables, or you're gonna make it like, hey, wow, this person actually took a lot of time to make an image with my name. So that's pretty cool. And that's the wow factor that we're gonna get with Nexweave. Now, let me show you how easy it actually is to use it and implement. So let's jump over to my desktop right now. All right, this is the deal that's going on right now, and it starts off at $49 for a lifetime deal. And if you guys would like to support me, do consider using that link in the description. Now, the $49 plan gets you 1,000 monthly credit, 60-second limit for the video. That means if the video is longer than 60 seconds, you can't use it in this plan. 5 GB of storage and unlimited campaigns. If you need more monthly credits, more storage, more users, and CNAME, license tier 2 would be the way to go. CNAME is custom domain. This is really useful when you're an agency and you're offering this to another person. Why? Because the links that are generated have your own domain. That means they don't find out who's actually providing the service. And if you need more limits and more things, then license tier 5 would be the way to go. You get more storage, more users, you even get 10 sub accounts for this. SMTP, CNAME for the agency, white label, and all that good stuff. Now, if that's something you want to use for reselling, then that's a good plan to go. License tier 2 would be the minimum, I think, would be useful for anyone because it has that CNAME, which is really useful. Okay, let's jump into Nexweave. Like I said before, in this video, I will be covering how to actually use it and what it actually does so you understand if this is the right deal for you or not. Plus, it's super easy to use. It's not complex at all. There's two things that we can do. We can use video for templates and we can use images or GIFs. We're gonna do a GIF template for this demo purpose, and we're gonna grab one of the public templates. There's several templates that you can grab right here. You can search for them if you like by category, or we can grab one from right here. So in this case, I'll grab this one for demo purposes. We're able to view what it actually does, okay? So in this case, we got variables that are right here. The variable is that little piece of text that we're gonna grab from somewhere, right? I will be showing you what I'll be using to automate this and grab that little variable text. Okay, so right now it has research and it's grabbing this variable. Then it says book a meeting with, and it has this company name. Okay, so let's clone this thumbnail. We think it's fine. Let's go ahead and use it. And now it's going to open up the editor. If I click on this text right here, it opens up the editor for this, and it's telling us what little piece of variable it's going to grab to put our own, all right? And we can edit the text, the font size, and all of good stuff, which we're not gonna get into that because it's straightforward. Next one we grab, again, here's a variable, username. And here's the variables that we're using, but what happens if we need another variable? Well, we can go into and list variables, and we can add another one right here so we can input the text over there. All right, and let's just say we like what we're looking at, do we? Yeah, it says research, Nexweave, the company name, then the username, and there's another variable. So let's add another piece of text right here. Click on it, drag it right there. And in this case, we're gonna remove that variable and let's add one we're not using. So domain's not used, so let's use this domain. And that's all we're gonna use, just the domain, all right? And we're saving this template, define data. We're gonna change the template name, demo video, and save. And there's several ways that we can use Nexweave. First is by the way that they provide, it's a CSV file where we add the information and we upload that file back so it generates our links for them. Honestly, I think not many people are gonna use that. I don't feel it's pretty useful. I would recommend using integrations to automate the process. They have several integrations available. You can see them right here. There's email providers, there's messenger bots, and there's public connected automates. This is what I'm going to use to automate the process of filling out a form and generating an image that will be sent out through an email. So this way is really useful because it's automated. So if you want to see how I actually built it, stick around. I will be showing you how I actually made this form. So let me show you the test that I've made. So I've just built this form right here and I'm going to automate. It's going to send an email to me with the image, with the information I just put. So for example, I'll add my name right here, the company, and my domain, sassmaster.net, and the email where I'll be sending this to. I'll submit it, that's sent. Let's go check out my Gmail because that's the way I automated it. Stick around if you want to learn how I did it, okay? Let's go view this. Go over here, let's refresh. Okay, here's the email. And there's the image with the variables I've added. Now we have to resize that text, obviously. But you get the idea. Here's the company name, my name, and the domain. Easy, automated, all right? So that's a really cool use case that you can use and you automate the process. Now, if you want to learn how I did this, stick around. All right, so what I did is I created a form that sends out a webhook. So this form could be any form that you want to use as long as it sends out a webhook, all right? And I'm using Public Connect to do the automation. Now let's do this together, all right? So basically, I capture the webhook and I get the variable information from that form, which is all this information right here. Don't worry, I'll show you how to actually use this information. All right, so we got the webhook. Next thing we want to do, and I'll actually delete this, I'll do it with you. Delete it. Yes. Okay, first thing we want to do with that information is we want to connect to Nexweave. Let's connect that. We're using an image GIF. We're connecting. I already have the API connected. It just asks for the API that's over there on Nexweave. And we're gonna grab the template that we're using. This is the only template that I have right now, so I'll grab this one. And these are the variables that that template is asking for. So, username. In this case, the username, we're using it as the name. So we're grabbing the variables from the form that we built, okay? Let's grab that variable there. Next one is the domain. Again, let's go search for that variable from the form that we built, okay? And the company name, where's that variable? It should say Sassmaster, right? Save and send request. Here's that image link, all right? Let me show you an incognito mode. This one's just created. And there it is, all right? So there's the variables. And I can send it again and it will be another image, another link, right? So what do we want to do with that image? Well, we want to send out an email. Let's close this one. Next automation process is we want to send out a Gmail. You could send it out to your email provider, like MailChimp, Automize, Sendinblue, or whatever, and just automate the whole process. In this case, we're gonna send out an email. I'm gonna connect. I already have it connected. There we go, save. And we're gonna put the information here. Who is the recipient name? So in this case, we'll grab it from the webhook again. Okay, this has nothing to do with Nexweave. This is from the form. The only part we'll be adding from Nexweave is in the email content, which is that little piece of image. The recipient email, again, we're grabbing it from the webhook. Here it is. The sender name, in this case, the sender will be Sassmaster. Sender email, this is email, reply to email, this one. The subject email is gonna say hello, and we're using the variable from here, the name, and the email content. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab the Nexweave link, this one, and we're gonna convert it to HTML so we can send it out to the email. For example, here's an example of the HTML. I'll grab this code right here. And I'll use it here on the email content. But we're going to replace this with every time that we fill it in the form, it's gonna convert it with Nexweave, and it's gonna give us this link. So we're gonna use a variable from Nexweave, all right? There we go. This variable is gonna be changed every time that we fill out the form. That's what's gonna make it unique and automated. Let's save it, okay? And we just automated the process. Now, this could be a form that you have embedded on your site to just capture the name and email when someone subscribes to the newsletter and we send them a thank you. with the image that says whatever you like from the template over there. But just like that, let me refresh it. In this case, we'll say John Doe company test. The domain will be test.com. And the email address, this is the one that it's gonna send it to. So let's just go ahead and submit that. Let's go over there, Gmail. Let's refresh it, and here it is. Hello, John Doe. And we should be seeing that image. There we go. There it is. That's the that variable that we just inputted over there on the form. It just sent it out automatically. Now that's possible using, obviously, Nexweave, using Pally Connect to do the integration, to do this automatically. Like I said before, this form could be something really simple where we're just asking for the name and email, and they just subscribed. And we can send out that email automatically with that really cool image. Or we could do an infinite amount of possibilities with Pally Connect. For example, after you grab all that information, instead of sending that email, well, we can connect to something else, like, I don't know, Automizing, and we'll send out an email, or we'll add other stuff like, let's see, another email provider, or we can send this out through a messenger using an automation bot to add that image to the automation and send out that messaging bot. But there's just a lot of things that you could do with it. Basically, that is what Nexweave does. I mean, it creates that image where that's a variable, and it gives us that link that we can use. And you can create a really nice looking email template to send out your users that those emails with those variables that look really nice. And you can give that little wow factor because it has the name on the image or in the video. If we create the video, same thing goes for it. I know there's a lot of other stuff that we can do, like there's other integrations, there's APIs, we can manage the websites, campaigns. But the idea of this video was to let you know how easy it is to use and implement in an automation with a real world situation. Well, there you go, guys. That is the Nexweave deal that's going on right now. Remember, if you guys would like to support me and if you find this video helpful, do consider using that link in the description. I thank you all for watching. My name is George and this is SaaS Master. I'll see you guys later.